that what you did, that's not consistent with who you are. That's not consistent with how you were raised. So the Holy Spirit never condemns. The Holy Spirit convicts to get us back on track. The Holy Spirit never condemns. The Holy Spirit doesn't say you're no good. The Holy Spirit convicts to say you're off track for a minute. And then the Holy Spirit says, this is like a GPS, rerouting, 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 to get you back on the track that God already had for you. There's a perfect path laid out for your life. And now every time you go astray, the Holy Spirit doesn't say, this is going off the cliff. The Holy Spirit is always trying to get us to get back on the track that God has for us. There is no condemnation. Therefore, no condemnation. There is no condemnation. There is no condemnation. There is no guilt. There is no shame. There is no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus. Please give God one more hand out of praise for you. One more hand out of praise. Let's just read this part of him to pick up the rest on Tuesday Bible study. Let's read this together. We can accept that we are no longer disappointed, since the shame and guilt from sin have been totally removed. Come on now, get that again. We can accept we are no longer disappointed, since shame and guilt from sin have been totally removed. Where's the sin and guilt? Where's the sin now? On whose account? Jesus' account. What's on our account? Righteousness. So this is imputation. Charge one's account. This is a figure to leave with for today. That here we are, and our sin got credited to Jesus' account. When he died, all the sins we've committed, going to commit, never committed, were now put on his ledger, his account. And now, the only thing on our account is his righteousness. So when God looks at us, he doesn't look at us as a failure, but looks at us as favor. He doesn't look at us as condemned, but looks at us as his children. That now he doesn't look at us as at this point being excluded. He looks at us as being extraordinary, because at this point, all that's on our account right now is his right. So just to go back very quickly here, so we take a look at this idea of rejected. So I want to go back here very quickly and just give you this one last part here, this idea about being rejected. I want to give you one definition here for rejected before we leave, just so you can have that for your notes. Write down the word for you were rejected, and I'm going to just give you one term for that. We'll pick up some other terms later on. But this one term, write down the word removed from proper place. Rejected. Removed from proper place. Removed from proper place. Removed from proper place. Talk about being rejected. So here's the question we talked about last week as we end today. Can believers ever be rejected by God? No. So rejected means to remove out of the proper place. What's our proper place as believers? Where is it? Acceptable or unacceptable? Acceptable. Always. That's our proper place. Now here's what I want to do. We'll pick up with these other. Remember, this is good right here. This ink also means empty. So we talked about before that condemnation, see, a building is condemned, is empty, it's no value, no good. We are never viewed as having no value to the Lord. So here's the point I want to go back in and make right now. So can believers ever be rejected by God? What's the answer to say?
No.
Now, that's just a little note. What's that?
No.
All right, so now, if you can read that with me, please read this. Therefore, because of Christ, I am totally accepted by God. I no longer have to fear rejection. Can you just give God a hand clap of praise? This is one that is just right there. I'm totally accepted by God. I no longer have to fear rejection. Now, here's the last part we finished with. Read all this with me. Christ was rejected. That's what the cross was about. Keep going. So we could be accepted. Read this one. I'm accepted by God, and it has nothing to do with me. Accepted by God doesn't have to do with my behavior. If I just believe, I'm already accepted by him as well. So last we finish this. Our acceptance and righteousness are not based on what? Our behavior, but belief. So keep on going. Our behavior does not change. Our behavior does not change. God's righteousness. Our behavior does not change. God's acceptance of us. Amen. God, we just bless you right now in the name of Jesus for who you are.